All right, welcome back everybody to another Deepvue tutorial. This is a very special one because it's the very first for our Deepvue mobile app. Today we'll be discussing the innovative swipe charts feature, which allows you to quickly go through different watch lists, organize your ideas quickly into your favorites menu with just a quick swipe of your finger. We'll go through the exact methodology, how you can do this, and hopefully answer a lot of questions along the way. So first things first, you want to go ahead and download the most recent version of the Deepvue mobile app. Just search in the App Store for Deepvue, download that, and make sure it's up to date. We'll be releasing a lot of great features soon, so make sure to stay on top of that. Once you've got it downloaded, you can navigate over to any watch list that you want. Right now, I've got my index ETF watch list, and just to show how to set up and click a chart, you can go ahead and click any of the symbols here. We'll load up the QQQ, and you can see that you can zoom in, zoom out, adjust the scaling. You can set up your layout, which if you don't know how to do it, basically what you want to do is click these three dots here. That brings up the menu. Then click load layouts right here, and then you can select among the different layouts that you have. Everything should sync properly between the desktop version as well as this mobile app. So here I am rocking my standard layout that I also use on the desktop version. So go back to the watch list. You want to click watch list again in the bottom right. That brings you back to this. And again, to click a symbol, bring up the chart, you can do that right there. You can adjust the time frame by clicking right there in the middle. And you can go ahead and X out of that. You can also navigate between your watch lists using this here. This isn't the swipe chart feature. We'll get to that in just a minute. But this is a quick way to quickly, go through your watch list and bring up another chart as you would like it to. To access the swipe chart feature, this is the big deal that we're releasing. It's a big update to the mobile app. It makes it really easy to go through a lot of ideas quickly. What you want to do is click the icon next to the edit pencil that looks like a full screen icon. And if you click that, you're now entered into swipe mode. Basically, what you want to do to go up, because we're at the last symbol in the list, is basically swipe down. That brings us up to UUP. We can swipe up again, and you can navigate through all your charts just like that. And you can, of course, go ahead and swipe down and go through a watch list or a starred screen as well using that. Then to swipe right, you basically add that symbol to your favorites. That's kind of a quick thing. You can of course undo that if you would like to. And you can also swipe to the left to delete a symbol from your watch list. So if you've got a large universe of symbols in a, a larger universe watch list, you can quickly go through that and pare it down and set your favorites to kind of your focus list. And then very quickly, you can run through hundreds of stocks and looking at their charts, just as easy as swiping up and swiping down and swipe right on any symbols that you'd like to investigate further. That's kind of a great workflow that you can set up. To exit the swipe chart, say you want to dive deeper into IWM, basically just click that icon again in the bottom left. That brings you up to the standard view. And you can go ahead and click the edit pencil if you'd like to add any drawings or the like. And again, you can adjust the chart, zoom in, zoom out, scroll back in time, change the time frame as you would like to. To show really, I think, how this shines, let's go ahead back to my watchlist tab. And up at the top, you can kind of scroll back and forth to the different watchlists that you have loaded. And here I've got the Deepvue Leaders screen starred on my desktop, which automatically creates a watch list version of it. So let's go ahead and load that up. You can see it's got my columns here. You can click the gear icon to adjust your columns as you would like to. I'm just using my standard set here. And what I love to do with swipe charts, because I personally look for tight areas, that's kind of my number one criteria for a potential entry. I am sorting by RMV, which you can see by the column being highlighted in blue. I'm sorting from lowest to highest, so I'm sorting from the tightest charts to the highest to the most price expansion charts. And we can go ahead and click BFH, enter swipe chart mode, and then look how quickly it is it is to swipe chart, find tight area stocks, add deck to my favorites, and then just keep on swiping. Docs looks good as well. We'll go ahead and add that. And this is just amazing. I mean, this is awesome. We can just keep swiping. Four looks great. Flagging after a nice power move up, we'll go ahead and flag that. And you could just kind of repeat this process until you've got a great watch list going. And then, of course, you can dive further. KVYO looks great as well. We'll go ahead and swipe right on that. And it's just super, super easy to find, high quality and basically build a watch list really easily. LTH looks great. Strong trend, just a little bit short-term extended. Melly, a little bit short-term extended. So I'm just kind of paring it down and looking for my criteria. S-Bucks looks pretty good. We'll go ahead and swipe right on that. Keep on swiping. Uber looks really good, right? That key level that I already had noted. So you can just see how easy it is. Actually, I want Venom, so we'll go ahead and swipe right on that. And if I decide I don't want Venom, I can press that undo button. I could remove it from a watch list. You can't remove it from a screen that's turned into a watch list. Well, you'll see if I'll swipe to the left, you can see cannot delete from presets. And that's because this is a screen that's been turned into a watch list. But I can always load my favorites list after this, and it'll actually show that and, you know, get a little bit more selective with stocks that are ready for the next few days. So Venom, we'll go ahead and add to favorites. It was already in favorites. We'll keep on swiping. Anet looks good as well. Downside reversal today, but still forming that tight range. You can see I've got my RMV loaded. If I open up the regular mode here, you can go ahead and click the moving averages. I've got RMV down here, volume. So you can kind of set up your layout as you would like to. And we'll even, and I'll show this right here, I'll switch to the other landscape layout. And this way you get even more chart when you're swiping through. So CN is like this. We'll go ahead and swipe up. Cyber looks pretty good. Not super tight, but I do want to keep an eye on this, so I'll add it to my favorites. We'll keep on swiping. FTNT also, let's swipe right on that. And it's just really fun and addicting. INSP looks great. Really tight right there at that key level. We'll keep on swiping. And let's switch back to this regular orientation here. Mazzy looks good as well. We'll go ahead and swipe right that. And you know, that's pretty much it. It's super easy to swipe up and down. I encourage you to try it out for sure. You'll see how quick and easy it is to organize your ideas. And now that we've got all these names in our favorites folder, let's go ahead and load that up, that watch list. And now we're going to dive deeper into this and load up swipe charts again and be a little bit more selective and say, you know, we went through our first process, which is, you know, find strong stocks. Now we're going to be a little bit more selective in turning this favorites watch list into our very specific focus list that is ready for the next few days. So UUP, definitely want to remove that. That was just as an example. NVIDIA, you know, downside reversal, not right, really super ready for, you know, not super tight at this moment. Still want to watch that, but it might not be on this focus list. So we'll get rid of that. IBIT, want to watch that, so we'll keep on moving. Four, want to keep watching that. EXP, not quite tight enough here. So you just kind of see my process where and an application of how to use this. First step, you know, use a larger watch list, universe screen, link a screen and set it as a watch list. Go through, add to favorites, any stocks that look pretty good. That's kind of the first step. Then the second step is to go into your favorites watch list and then be even more selective and then turn the result of this after you've gone through, remove the ones you don't really want. And that is what you're left with. You're left with a really strong focus list, all in just a few quick, easy minutes using the swipe chart. So I hope you guys really enjoy this. Let us know your feedback down below, ways we can make it better. We'd love to hear it. This is just kind of iteration one, but it's already fantastic and a part of my workflow. You know, it's so easy to do everything on your phone, and you can just bring up the desktop if you want to get more into in-depth technical analysis. But again, even on the mobile app, you're able to zoom in and out, you know, move things around, adjust scaling, zoom in, you know, change time frames. We'll go over to a 50-minute time frame and, you know, adjust that scale, all of that. So it's really quick and easy to do even on the mobile app. So hopefully you guys have fun with this. Let us know your thoughts down below, as well as future features that you'd like to see from the mobile app. So thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you guys in future videos. Take care.